Yeah, you lied. Spent the whole summer trying to be at the wrong place at the right time. But I know what's mine when I see it. I know. I know, I know, I know when I see it. Riding down the 405. If I should make it right. When I pulled up to the light, and then my phone started ringing. Sure, it's in the dark and those I love, yeah, yeah. Don't know why, but I know a sign when I see it.
Welcome to the Leroy Fury Cast, episode 15. Let me look it up first. I think it's episode 15. I'm not too sure. Leroy Fury Cast playlist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, episode 15, featuring Matthew Kim. Before you ask, no, we not doing Rush Hour 4. They tried that shit on CBS with the TV show. Shit got canceled. I'm not going to play Jackie Chan. He not going to play Chris Tucker, all right? We ain't doing it. I'm eating my breakfast right now. It's mad snowy outside. You know, I was thinking about, like, going around to different fucking houses with a shovel and some gloves saying, yo, I'll shovel your driveway and your sidewalk and your stairs, like, $15 a pop. I was going to do that, but I just put some coconut oil on my hands. I ain't got time to be dipping my hands in the frosty ass ice and shit. You know what I'm saying, play? Motherfucker got coconut on. I ain't trying to dip these coconut sticks in some motherfucking ice bucket challenges. You feel me? Rest in peace to my nigga Stephen Hawkins. Ew. You know what I'm saying? Eh. Yeah. Rest in peace to Craig Mack, too. Craig Mack, Stephen Hawkins, combine them. Here comes a brand new flavor in your ear. It's time for a new flavor in your ear. I'm kicking new flavor in your ear. The black hole theory is real in your ear. Whatever. Podcast time. Let's go.
Like one shower from spring break to like when school ended.
If you're a man, we don't have to shower every single day because dicks are just out. But vaginas, they have to shower every day because that fish aroma will intensify. See, if we get stinky, what we smell like? Shit and onions.
Yeah.
Women, fish shit and onions.
Fish.
See, that's why they have to take showers. That's why they so fucking sensitive.
No. But didn't you think, isn't it weird that people didn't have showers like, you know, 1,000 years ago? So we all evolved.
No, back in the day, in like the village,
yeah.
In like the village, the metaphorical village.
Yeah, yeah, the village.
The stinkiest man got the most pussy.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they're like, oh, that's a man. He smells like a man.
But the same logic, the stinkiest woman probably got the most pussy. Because they couldn't shower either.
Man, the smallest or the...
The stinkiest.
Oh, definitely.
The stinkiest woman probably got the most pussy.
They didn't have Vagisil back in the day.
So wouldn't...
When they had their period, it just blood everywhere.
So wouldn't it make sense that like we'd like... be attracted, but whenever you smell a bad pussy, you're just like, oh,
it's nasty. But I don't hate seafood.
That's true. Okay.
So it's like
it doesn't smell like seafood. It smells like
some fish juice.
It smells like rust.
Rust. I've never been with rust.
It smells like metal.
I smelled nothing, and I smelled fish juice.
Did you get to eat out the people at the ranch?
You can't do that.
You can't do that?
You can't transmit bodily fluids.
No bodily fluids?
Like, I love kissing
in
the mouth.
Can you use a dental dam?
I'd have to ask them.
Okay.
Or you could ask them. You find out.
Can you? So what if you're really rich?
Really rich?
Yeah. Is that like on the menu? Can you pay to like transfer bodily fluids?
No, because that'll ruin their career.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because if they catch something, then they can't work anymore. They get tested every week.
What if you paid them, like, so there's not a sign on the menu?
What explain.
Like, you know how you have the menu?
Yeah.
Like, couldn't you, is there like a $1,000 option where it's like, oh, you get tested and then you come in and they, you like make out and stuff?
Nah.
No, it's not.
Then no transmitted body fluid.
Dang. What was the most expensive menu item?
Something for $20,000.
$20,000?
I didn't want that.
What was it?
I think it's going to Playland.
Doors opening.
You got a Playland?
Playland means you get to like do a scenario. Like, they have a Playland. You could be in a classroom, a locker room, like different like scenarios.
How long do you get for $20,000?
I didn't worry because I'm not paying that.
You should have asked.
I'm not paying $10,000 or $5,000.
You should have asked.
I'm not paying any of
that. You should have asked for $20,000 how much money, what that would do.
I might ask next time.
That's crazy. $20,000.
I might ask next time because some girls don't have menus. They just say, what do you want?
And
if you smooth with them,
yeah,
they'll give you a great price. Some girls straight up got a book. Like, this is what we got.
Yeah, yeah, like this is the first girl.
Yeah, Lily, love her. Yeah. Second girl, they say, what do you want to do? I said, I'm trying to save this much money because this other girl said she gave me a blowjob for this amount, so I got this so much left.
Yeah.
She said, I'll charge you this much. I was like, that's it?
Dang.
Straight, let's do it.
Let's do
for
it.
30 minutes, that much?
Yo, how many is in the, so how you were there for like 3 days?
One day.
A
layover.
Oh,
I left my house, I jacked off, ate breakfast,
yeah,
went to Dulles Airport.
Drink a bottle of water?
Yeah, drank a little half.
A bottle of water.
Went to Dulles Airport,
yeah,
waited, ate a Subway sandwich, got on a plane. Flight was 3 hours and 40 minutes.
Yeah.
From Dulles to Las Vegas.
Yeah.
Got there early, said, hey, because they sent a ride to pick you up. I said, yo, I'm here, I'm ready. So whenever y'all come through. She's like, all right, cool. 20 minutes later, they pulled up, got in the car. They explained everything to me. Said, these girls are independent contractors. They got their own prices. Do what you want to do. So just like, you know, just be cool with it. If you can't afford it, say no.
Yeah.
You don't got to. If you can't afford it, because you can say no.
Yeah.
Like, all right, cool. I'm in the back seat.
You can't say no.
So I'm in the back seat, like, listening to my headphones, looking at the mountains at nighttime. They have stars and lights, because no lights in the desert. So it's just beautiful as shit. I'm listening to like the Twin Peaks theme song. It's fucking amazing. Pull up to the spot, he ring the doorbell, I give him a tip, $20, because the ride's free.
Dang.
So you can drive from Vegas to the ranch, an hour drive.
Wow.
Free.
Oh, that's good, that's good.
Just tip him, so I give him $20. You know, I should have paid 80, because Lyft would charge you 80. So I said, here goes 20. Went into the jump, the shift manager said, all right, sit right here on the couch. You got a schedule with Lovecraft? Yeah, all right, just sit on the couch and wait. I'm sitting there waiting, she come around the corner. Beautiful in real life. In a robe, like, you can't see nothing, like, everything's closed up, she got a robe on, like, hey, come on, crack a little joke, being nice to me and shit. She pulled her book down, I'm like, I can't afford that, that's nice, let's see what about that. Give me go and I pay for that, go back, I take my shower, then I do a full process. This is a lot of information I'm giving you, I do a full process. Wristbands,
oh, yeah, yeah.
And a headband.
So you got the condom and the
no,
rubber band?
No.
No condom?
I had the rubber band, she had her own condom. I didn't bring it because I suspected they had their own. Yeah. So I took my rubber band, put it around the base of my dick.
Yeah.
So I can stay hard.
Below the balls or below the balls?
No, base of my dick. My balls are swinging in the wind.
Okay.
This is my dick. These are the balls.
I heard if it's below the balls, you can go longer.
I don't want to do that much. I'm not paying for that much.
Okay.
All I need is 30 or 15 minutes.
Okay. They charge you by the hour too?
No, just whatever you want.
Oh, dang.
Then once the clock run out, you stop. Second girl, 30 minutes was up. She said, 5 more minutes. I'm like, oh, you like this shit?
Dang.
She said, she was on her back. And I had her legs up. I was just like, yeah, 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 yeah. And then they bing, bing, bing. I said, all right, time's up. My dick's still hard, though.
Yeah.
And I ain't met yet. Yeah. She was like, 5 more minutes. I was like, 5 more minutes? Fuck yeah. So I'm like, all right, cool. What am I doing 5 minutes? Fuck it. All right, the 30 over. Let me just have fun. Put both legs together. Go balls deep in her, and I go like the Incredible Hulk. I just go like no. I was just like, and she was just like. then I took her legs right, picked them up, slammed on her side. Now we face to face. I said, choke me, I'm choke you. You know I stutter when I talk. I said, choke me, and I'm choke you. She choked me, I choked her. Then I'm like, all right, I'm about to nut. Now I said, I'm about to nut. Just sit right here and say nice things to me. But she was just like, I did something nice to you with my tongue. She gave me head first. My head was crazy. I'm like, she was like, I did something nice with my tongue. I think a couple other things I can do with my tongue too. I'm like, just, yeah. I took the rubber band off, put it around my wrist, still got the condom on. Then I nut. Then she take the condom, put it in the trash can, give me a napkin, a wipe off, and say, that's a great way to start your morning.
Dang.
It was like 12 in the afternoon.
That's hilarious.
Then after that, I tried to fuck another girl, and they said, your credit card maxed out.
Oh.
Like, I spent too much today. Oh. So now I gotta, like, just divvy up and get cheaper girls. Because Lovecraft is really expensive.
Yeah, yeah.
I fucked up for 30. I should have fucked up for 15.
Dang.
I fucked up for 30. I spent too much. And then Kristen is cheap. Oh, you good? All right.
That's amazing.
And income taxes come in, so I might be going there back earlier.
Yeah.
I plan on going back next November. I might go back August on my birthday when I turn 25. Oh!
Tax returns.
Yeah. Let them cart pushing checks back
maybe
pile up.
Maybe they'll, do you think they'll recognize you?
I'm going to wear the same pink hoodie.
Same thing.
Hopefully. I don't DM them too much on Twitter because I want to annoy them.
Yeah.
Because if you annoy them, they'll be like, dude, you're wasting my time. Give me money or shut the fuck off.
Yeah.
So I say, I'll see you in August or May.
Dang.
So I'm going to see you in August. Three girls in a day. That's my goal.
That's the goal?
That's my goal.
How do you do it?
I got energy.
All right.
Leroy Fury Cast. Out. Did you enjoy the podcast? It's over. It's already over. 8 minutes. I talked to him for like 8 minutes, maybe 7 minutes, 58 seconds. I ain't count the shit up. But whatever. You didn't pay to watch this shit or listen. So fuck you, bitch. You get what you pay for. You didn't pay for nothing, you don't get nothing. I gotta finish my breakfast now. What am I having on this motherfucking... Get a remote control. What am I having on this fucking 33 degree Wednesday? What am I having on hump day for my second breakfast, nigga? Oh, I got one little bit of cantaloupe. Wakanda forever. I got some eggs. I got the eggs with the motherfucking garlic and herb powder on them on a paper plate. It's biodegradable, so if I litter, it don't matter. Oh, and it's recyclable, but I don't litter because I ain't no bitch. And I got the hash brown patties, the kind that give you cancer, the real good shit, you know what I'm saying? Hey, whatever, bitch. I got some more shit to show y'all if y'all want to watch. If you don't want to watch, fuck you. You ain't got to watch, bitch. I ain't forcing nobody to do shit because I'm not a forceful person. I get consent. Like the great prophet, Little B, the bass god, says, no booty, no consent. More podcasts coming at you. This is a commercial break. This episode is brought to you by Leroy Furious. I ain't got no sponsors. Who the fuck gonna sponsor this shit? A smart person would. No sponsors? That means everybody's dumb. Yep.
Sing a bunch of songs, do the fuck I want to do. I would dance on this motherfucker, but I don't want nobody to come on this while I'm dancing. See, singing, I could just go, shut the fuck up. But if I'm dancing, I gotta run back, grab my camera, hit stop, then walk off of it. They make an announcement and shit. This type of shit I do on train, though. I can't dance on the train, because I'm a really skillful dancer. But if I dance on the train, somebody walk in on me, I gotta fucking put the camera down. I gotta find my camera where I set it up to film myself. Hit record to stop it. Save myself the embarrassment. Or as some Middle Eastern people say, embarrassment. I heard one Middle Eastern motherfucker say, irritating. He said, irritating. He said, irritating. It's irritating. This weather is so hot, it's irritating. I say embarrassing. Embarrassing. Whatever shit.
Oh man.
I just left La Fogata. That's my favorite place to perform right now because the acoustics are always really good in that room. You can always really, it's intimate. You can like capture the audience and shit like that. It's good shit, man. This is Leroy Furycast, episode motherfucking, what's this, episode 14? Yeah. I'm filming this shit at 9:45 p.m. Thursday, June 22nd. I'm on the train ready to go home, but the train just sitting there chilling. So I'm gonna just talk to y'all motherfuckers that's watching until the motherflipping train come up. You know what I'm saying? Whatever, man. I win, boy. Y'all like this joint? This is my shit here. I like this song. Off the movie Frank. Crank that shit up. Michael Fassbender, a bad motherfucker. Yeah, man. I want to see Michael Fassbender and motherfucking Dwight Henry from Beast of the Southern Wild, the movie together. Just complete opposite actors. I want to see them work together. That's what I want to see. Michael Fassbender and Dwight Henry in a buddy cop movie. It's going to be a comedy, but it's not going to be that funny. It's going to be like a dark comedy. It's going to be hilarious and dramatic. I want to see that shit. No fake accents. Everybody talk how they normally talk. Michael Fassbender and Dwight Henry. Is his name Dwight Henry? I don't know. He was a Hush Puppies. He was Quvin J. Wallace's character, father. He was Hush Puppies' dad on Beast of the Southern Wild. I want to see him. And I want to see... Is his name Dwight Henry? I should look it up first. So I got to turn my phone on underground. And look for the shit. I would say myself and Michael Fassbender as buddy cops, but I ain't no fucking actor. I wouldn't even try that shit. I mean, if the money right, obviously I'm gonna try that shit, because money's really useful in this society. But honestly, I don't really give a fuck. I'm about to remove the dollar from my life altogether. I'm gonna just go to local libraries and shit to charge this camera up and film myself talking and upload the shit. Other than that, I don't give a fuck. Look cool. I be chilling like shit, man. Oh, I got service down this motherfucker. Yeah. I'm doing a podcast underground right now. This is the legit underground podcast, though. Niggas don't even know what time it is. Dwight Henry. I think that's his name, Dwight Henry, man. His name Dwight Henry? Yep, that's his name. I was right. I know what the fuck I'm talking about. Dwight Henry, Quvenzha Ney Wallace. Beast of the Southern Wild. I love that movie. It's a really cool movie. Hush, puppy. You gotta crack that crab open with your hand. Don't use no hammer. You ain't no little girl. You a big girl. Goddamn, come on, hush, puppy. Dwight Henry, son. Man, tight. He played Wink. Nashville, Tennessee. Yeah, you tight. What else he been at, man? Oh, they got my man. They got baby Winnie over there. Like, she's crazy, man. What's wrong? That's why we all looking like that. That nigga 6'2". He not a nigga. But that man 6'2". From New Orleans. Oh, that's cool, man. It's good to know where people are from. It's always interesting. Good to know that type of stuff. Warning shot. Oh, he gonna play Marvin Gaye's father on the Marvin Gaye movie. That's crazy. He's in a short film called, and Jesse L. Martin is playing Marvin Gaye, as he should. Thank you. It's finally comes to life. Julian Temple is gonna direct it. You heard it here first, folks. Oh shit. You heard it here first, folks. Everybody get a biopic, my nigga. My homies. The brothers and sisters of America need to unite and make more biopics. I've been talking for 8 minutes. I'm gonna talk for 2 more minutes until this motherfucking train start or until a passenger gets on. But if there's no passenger, I'm gonna just stay on. The funny thing about passengers is half of you bitches can't even spell passenger. Flip. Yeah. What is in the most deaf right now? You were rocking with the best, you were rocking with the best, you were rocking with the best, with the care. Yeah. And now when